That should work.
What's my belt?
Having this regular meeting of the Quartzsite Town Council to order Tuesday, January 24th at 9 o'clock. Invocation, is there any member of the church group present in the audience like to give the invocation? None? All right, well, I'll forego the invitation. Pledge allegiance, please. Let's go.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, I'll make a motion to approve the agenda and the addendum. Oh, I'm sorry. Roll call, please.
Mayor Lazarga.
Here.
Vice Mayor Cowell.
Here.
Councilmember Anderson.
Here.
Councilmember Kelly.
Here.
Councilmember Jewett.
Here.
Councilmember Winslow.
Here.
All right, now I'll make a motion that we approve the agenda, including the addendum.
Second.
Okay. Item's been moved and seconded. Open for discussion. Barbara?
I'd like to move number two up to in the middle of the place because we have a lawyer and it is taking time, so we need to...
That's fine. We can move that. Anything else?
Do we need to make a motion?
No, I can take that anywhere I'd like to.
Okay.
Anything else? Okay, none. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, signify by saying nay. Reports and announcements. Pat, go ahead.
Good morning. Please remember to turn off your cell phones. Okay, I have an update on the vendor permit. A year ago to this date, the total sold was 1,278. This year, the total sold is 1,327. At this time, Mr. Martin Brandon would like to read a statement.
Actually gives me an opportunity to read an excerpt of one of my favorite all-time speeches. It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marked by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. That's Theodore Roosevelt said that, Paris, France, 23 April 1910. The reason I bring up critics is one of the town critics has published false information concerning the administration and government of the town of Quartzsite for the legality of this meeting. Doug Gilbert published yesterday that today's meeting is illegal because the notice and agenda announcing the meeting was posted 23 hours and 24 minutes before the meeting and not a full 24 hours before the meeting. He is wrong. Whether his error stems from ignorance, apathy, or malice, we may never know with certainty. But we can know that only one of three possibilities exists. Either Mr. Gilbert has never read the law and is making things up out of whole cloth, in which case he's apathetic. He has read the law but was incapable of understanding it, in which case he's ignorant. Or he has read and understood the law and published this false statement knowing it to be false, in which case he is a liar. Whatever the case, the facts remain that physical copies of the agenda were posted as required by law at least 24 hours before this meeting, and a technological problem prevented the posting of the agenda for the meeting until approximately 9:35 a.m. yesterday. ARS section 38431.02A4B states, the public bodies of cities and towns shall post all public meeting notices on their website or on a website of an association of cities and towns and give additional public notice as is reasonable and practicable as to all meetings. This is the important part. A technological problem or failure that either prevents the posting of public notices on a website or that temporarily or permanently prevents the use of all or part of the website does not preclude the holding of the meeting. This meeting is legal. There has been no violation of the open meeting law. There has been no violation of the agreement between this council and the Attorney General.
Vice Mayor Cal.
Yes. I have a report on the assisted living project that's going on the east side of town. I would like to announce that the assisted living project is alive and well. Unfortunately, Arizona Department of Housing held up this project and ultimately did not fund it. MCD, the company working on the assisted living, has presented their project to the USDA in Phoenix. This is an important project for the town of Quartzsite and the county. MCD has discussed phasing of the project with the town in an effort to get the project funded more easily. Their plans have been approved and USDA has agreed on the importance of the project for the community. They have been working very, very hard to get this funding. They've gone through several processes with the different banks and have been, with the economy the way it is, they're just worried about it. But we can fill these, if they had two of them, we could fill it. This need is so great. So I'm just happy to be able to announce that it still looks like it's going forward and we're doing fine. Thank you.
Anything else?
That's it.
All right, moving on, consent agenda. Can I have a motion, please?
I make a motion to approve consent agenda 1 through 3.
Second.
I have been moved and seconded to approve the consent agenda items 1, 2, and 3. Open for discussion. Any discussion? Being none, we'll go to the vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 All those opposed signify by saying nay. All right. In lieu of attorneys being here, we're going to move item 2 to first order of business. Alex Taff.
This is discussion and possible action to go into executive session pursuant to ARS 38-431.039A, 3, and 4 for the purpose of legal representation and advice consultation regarding the tax appeal case TX 2011-00179, Desert Gardens Mobile Homes, LLC versus the town of Quartzsite.
All right, I'll make a motion we go into executive session to discuss the
Second.
Item's been moved and seconded, open for discussion. Being none, we'll go to the vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say nay. None, we're adjourned into executive session.
Thank you.
All right, reconvening into the regular meeting. Roll call, please.
Mayor Lasaga.
Here.
Vice Mayor Count.
Here.
Councilmember Anderson.
Here.
Councilmember Kelly.
Here.
Councilmember Jewett. Councilmember Winslow.
Here.
This is approve or reject to direct staff to proceed with phase one of the BLM land sale.
I'll make a motion that we direct staff to proceed with phase one of the BLM land sale.
Second.
I have been moved and seconded. I have open for discussion.
Originally, this entire BLM land sale package was approximately 1,232 acres. The funding, which is the Federal Land Transaction Facilitation Act, or FLTFA, it has been approved every year in order to proceed with this sale, but they would prefer that we do a smaller unit than the original 1,232 acres. So we've identified a phase one, which is portions of section 21, 22, 23, and 29. I believe on the website all the sections are listed up there. The reason we chose these is because there are issues with rights of way, especially down Mockingbird, where some land doesn't have as much access as it needs to. And by selling portions of this, that access can be created. Additionally, in these sections, we have areas where they are small parcels, acre and a quarter, so that the individual can buy property at BLM rates. There are some bigger parcels for development as well, but the parcel size range is anywhere from acre and a quarter all the way through, I believe, 30 acres, is that correct? Yeah, to 30 acres. The sale is an auction process, public auction, so that everyone has an opportunity to do this. The property currently is zoned rural agricultural, so we have kept the zoning that way so that it does not impact on the cost of the land assessment when the auction does go up. BLM will pay for this. It's their, they pay for the process, and of course they take the funds from the auction. So we should know fairly shortly if this FLIPFA has passed for the year 2012. It has passed for several in a row, so they're not, they, meaning BLM, are not anticipating any problems with it. They did actually approve our nominating package last year, due to the turbulence of things, they did not contact us.
You just, your last paragraph of your report there, talking about the right-of-way.
These are the two well sites. They're not actually part of the auction. We have, that would be a direct sale process to us. Right now, those two well sites, we pay a lease amount on each one of them. And this direct sale would allow us not to have to do that anymore. We would own the property outright for the purposes of those well sites. Just like we own the land pact, just like here for the town property.
We've been working on this for a long time, especially when they say, oh, it shouldn't take more than 2 weeks. Yeah, almost 3 years ago.
Anybody else?
I just want to get the, make sure that if nothing else, we get the right of way for the lost sites on Coconut Trail. I just noticed that it's already been included in the capital improvements, so for the water part, so, yeah.
If I can comment on that briefly.
Go ahead.
The county and has RPP, which is Recreation and Public Purpose Lease, right alongside of and overlapping our right-of-way for the Quail Trail and well site. Somebody at BLM many years ago didn't do that right. And so they're going to have to sort that out and redefine, give a new legal description for the county's justice court piece and then our right-of-way. The one property is overlaps the other. And it was simply a mistake on the part of the BLM people that did the legal description. They're aware of it. The legal department down there is working on it now.
So is the county going to have some heartburn over this? Or?
Not to my knowledge. They're aware of it. And the district manager, which is out of Lake Havasu, Angie Lara, is aware of it as well. We have made sure that everybody is on the same page with this. And, but we discovered it while we were doing the legal description. It's not complicated, it's just time consuming.
We're finding anything with BLM is?
Yeah.
All right, anything else? All right. Being none, we'll go ahead and go to vote. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All those opposed, signify by saying nay. Item passed. All right, item three, Terry.
This is a grant application for a new van for our service. It's a 50-tree tank grant. It's a van service for our handicapped and the elderly. We need to replace some of our vans. there's very little cost to the town. I'm not quite sure what the amount is. $10,000 is the cost to the town for the van. And that would be also, it would be a wheelchair lift van.
I'll make a motion to approve application to ADOT for a new transit van with lift.
Second.
Motion's been moved and seconded. Open for discussion. Any discussion?
We will not receive this van for 2 years, so this is something that we need to do to probably replace one of our vans. It's not like we're adding to the force of a van, but all we're doing is getting ready to replace one. And like I said, we won't receive this for 2 years, so it's something that we need to do now.
That's correct. They are trying to shorten the time frame that it takes us to get them a vehicle, so there's the possibility we could receive it in 18 months instead of 2 years.
And that money comes out of her? Or is it general? Go ahead.
That money does come out of general. We did budget for it this year. As a grant match, and it was approved in the budget. It'll have to carry forward for next year. We've done that on all the vans that we have. The mini vans are about a $2,000 match, and these vans are about $10,000. And that's what we budgeted.
So the plan is to carry forward $10,000 from this year's budget into next year?
From the general fund as part of the transit budget as a grant match.
Anybody else?
Just a kind of question. What's the story on the Dodge van? By the children's library, the doors are open, the ramps down, and good for it.
I don't believe that is operational. We probably need to sell it or to auction it. So at this time, we don't have room with a lift at all. We have two. And we use them.
They have lifts.
Yes. Because we run local and distance runs. And if one is down for service, we still have another one so that we can provide service to the elderly. We've had requests for more service presented to the Health and Development Services Board and from the community directly to administration because of the fact that the senior center is open 5 days a week for lunch, and we only run locally 3 days a week. And we overlap one of those days with a distance run. Usually it's either UMR or Lake Havasu.
Can we work on getting another van? Being it takes so long and we are in dire need of another van?
That would be part of the budget process, and yes, we could do that. It would be something to consider when you review the budget process for the next fiscal year.
I believe that's on pulling our five-year plan that we put into ADOT.
Yeah, we have to project over length of time, and we did add that. Our van is a very popular service.
Anything else? All right, being none, we'll go ahead and go to the vote. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, signify by saying nay. Now an aye to pass. All right, that's it on the evening.